Six billionaires that control America are playing Scrabble with antique tarot. They've just unearthed another pyramid in a bomb-proof cellar at Fort Knox. Not even the FBI knows who. They give orders to J.E. Hoover through the metal phone girl at the robot transmitter on top of RCA. You can see the new fortune officers with their eyeglasses and gold skulls, silver teeth flashing up their shit-mouthed grin, weeping in their martinis. There is no secret to the success of the six billionaires that own all time since the Gnostic revolt in Egypt. They built the Sphinx to confuse my sex life. Who fucked the void? Why are they starting that war all over again in Laos over neutral mind? Is the United States CIA Army overthrowing somebody like Angelica Balabanoff again? 6,000 movie theaters, 100 million television sets, a billion radios, wires and wireless crisscrossing the hemispheres, semaphore lights and Morse, all telephones ringing at once to connect every mind by its ears to one vast consciousness. This time apocalypse. Everybody waiting for one mind to break through. Man, prophet with two eyes, dare all creation with his dying tongue and say, I am. Messiah, swallow back his death into his stomach, gaze through the great pupils of his body's eyes, and look in each eye, man, that eyeglass, fearful, myriad look that might be God's eye, see through death, that now are Clark and ego and psychiatrist reading man law. Write newspapers with broadcasts to cover their fears that their own Messiah must come when all of us conscious at once break through to all other consciousness to say the word, I am, as spoken by a certain God, millennia knew and waited till this one century. Now all sentience broods and listens, contemplative and hair full of rain. For 15 years inside New York and San Francisco, what millions know and hark to hear, and death will tell, but many strange magicians in buildings listening inside their own heads, or clouds over Manhattan Bridge, or strained through music, messages come to I am from the central one. Come, blow the cosmic horn and waken every Tiglon and clown sentience throughout the vasting circus. In the name of God, pick up the microphone, call networks announcing suchness that I am, utter a million old gods in their beards that had been sleeping at evening radios, talking to myself again, cackling in their own larynx, said the Messiah turning a dial to remember his last broadcast. I scare myself. I eat my hand. I swallow my own head. I stink in the inevitable bathroom of death this being requires. Oh, widen the area of consciousness. Oh, set my throne in space. I rise to sit in the midst of the starry visible, calling all beings in dirt from the ant to the most frightened prophet that ever clomb towered a vision planets crowded in one vast spaceship headed toward Andromeda, that all lone soul in Iowa or Harkland joined the lone, set forth, walk naked like a Hebrew king, enter the human cities and speak free. At last the man-god come that hears all fantasy behind the matter babble in his ear and walks out of his cosmic dream into the cosmic street, open mouth to the first consciousness. God's woke up now, you seraphim. Call every man with trumpet, microphone, and telegraph. Hail every sleepwalker with holy name. Life is waving. The cosmos is sending a message to itself. Its image is reproduced endlessly over TV, over the radio. The babble of Hitler's and Claudette Colbert's voices got mixed up in the bathroom radiator. Hello, hello, are you the telephone? The operator is singing, we are the daughters of the universe. Get everybody on the line at once. Plug in all ears in being by Lord Speaker Newspeak, secret message, handwritten electronic impulse traveling along Ray's electric spider web, magnetism shuddering on one note. We, mustached disc jockeys trembling in mantric excitement, flowery patterns bursting over the broken couch, drapes falling to the floor in Saint-Jean Perse's penthouse, Portugal's water is running in all the faucets on the SS Santa Rosa, chopping machines descend on the pre-dawn tabloid, the wire services are hysterical and send too much message, they're waiting to bam out the Armageddon, millions of rats reported in China, smoke billows out of New York hospital's furnace smokestack, I am writing millions of letters a year, I correspond with hopeful messengers in Detroit, I am taking drugs and leap at the postman for more correspondence. Man is leaving the earth in a rocket ship. There is a mutation of the race. We are no longer human beings. We are one being. We are being connected to itself. It makes me cross-eyed to think how the mass media assemble themselves like Congolese ants for a purpose. In the massive clay mound, an undiscovered huge queen is born. Africa wakes to redeem the old cosmos. I am masturbating in my bed. I dreamed the new stranger touched my heart with his eye. He hides in a loft side street in Hoboken. The heavens have covered East 2nd Street with snow. All day I walk in the wilderness over white carpets of city. We are redeeming ourselves. I am born. The Messiah has awoke in the universe. I announce the new nation in every mind. Take power over dead creation. I am naked in New York. A star breaks through the blue skull of the sky out the window. I seize the tablets of the law. The spectral Buddha and the spectral Christ turn to a stick of shit in the void. A fearful idea. I take the crown of the idea and place it on my head and sit a king among the reptile devas of my karma. I in every forehead sleeping waxy in the light gone inward to dream of fearful Yahweh or the atom bomb. All these eternal spirits to be wakened, all these bodies touched and healed, all these lack love, suffering, the hate, dumbed under the rainbows of creation. Oh, psychiatrist, the means of heaven at hand, thy rocks and my rocks are nothing. The identity of the moon is the identity of the flower thief. I and the police are one in revolutionary numbness. York, mercy, the octopus, it cometh over the void and makes whistle its lone-mouthed flute, you me forever. Stop arguing, cosmos, I give up so I be. I receive a happy letter from Ray Bremser, exiled home in Jersey jail. Clocks are a building for 1,000 years, ticking behind metalloid-esque electronico-clankered industries, smokeless and silent mind city. Dawn of the ages, man, thy alarm rings in sweet myriad mornings through every desperate card street. Saints wait in each metropolis for message to assassinate the old idea that 2,000-year-old I-God man thought was being secret mystery, unbearable God above, Yahweh alien, handless, tongueless to poor man who'll scream for mercy on his deathbed.